7 seconds per, or you can only get 7 transactions through a second, whereas when you look at Visa and MasterCard that are in tens of thousands, right. When do you get, for example, the Bitcoin blockchain being as fast as Visa or MasterCard?
Yeah, so I don't know if that will ever happen for Bitcoin, but I do think we will see blockchains as fast as Visa or MasterCard within the next couple of years.
Next couple of years. And what about then the cost of changing fiat, so my dollar or my euro or my pound, into crypto assets?
Right. So right now, that's, you know, if you use Coinbase, that's around 150 to 400 basis points if you use a debit card or ACH from your bank account. And I think within the next year, that'll be down to 50 basis points. Maybe not Coinbase, maybe some upstart. But I think if you see solutions like Bakkt going live, the Fidelity stuff, all these sorts of new exchanges popping up, I think it's going to drive costs down.
Why wasn't Fidelity in the announcement of more institutional accessibility more of a catalyst to the market yesterday? Why aren't we seeing more pickup? Because that used to move the significantly.
Yeah, I mean, 2 years ago, that would have been a huge bull run if that news was announced. But I think at this point, the market really is, I think, waiting for actual adoption to start to pick up.
And when does that happen?
To get that, you need scalability. And the reason is, if you look at the internet, it's easy to say, well, you just create an app, get some users, and then you solve the scalability problems. But here, these are all markets. And so if you don't have scalability, you don't have market makers. And so you don't have liquidity.
So Joey, you're not seeing...
He makes a great point, and if you're not too sure about this or you don't really understand, I would definitely wait to kind of educate yourself on cryptocurrency and understand what the scalability issues are before you invest too heavily. Now, I do recommend having some skin in the game, and if you want to put in a small amount, that's the great thing about crypto. You can invest very, very small amounts. You just have to be careful with the fees. And I highly recommend checking out Robinhood. There are no fees with Robinhood. And you can check that on the bottom of the link of this video. But for long-term growth, it's very important that the scalability issue is solved. And like I said, we might be a year or two away, but I'm going to go ahead and continue to purchase crypto assets, especially since the prices have been stable. Now, I'm not putting in my entire portfolio into crypto. It's still a small part. But as the stock market gets weaker, I am going to increase my crypto position and also my cash position and kind of monitor the news and see what happens. But let me know what you guys think about this, and I will talk to you soon.